feeling the sunrise.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to be doing a 10-minute makeup look. So I have some products here that I think that you can accomplish. Henry, you cannot be the star of the show anymore. Shh, please. Silence. So yeah, I have products here that I think you could use to accomplish a 10-minute makeup look, a 5-minute makeup look, 15, an hour and a half, whatever you feel like you need to do. Yeah, I just want to show that you can get your makeup done with a lot of products in 10 minutes, whether you are a student, whether you're a mom, whether you are me and you don't want to do your makeup in the morning for work. So yeah, if you want to see how I accomplish whatever look I'm going to do, if you want to see it, please keep watching and I will talk to you guys soon. Bye. To start off this look today, I'm going to be using the IT Cosmetics CC Cream, and this is in the shade Medium. As you can see, it kind of looks like I've already started because my camera cut off the first part. But I look kind of like I'm using peanut butter on my face. Don't worry, guys, it's not. The CC Cream is really good if you have any kind of discoloration on the skin, if you do like more of a full coverage. Yeah, I like to prep my eyes with it as well, especially if I am in a rush and I just want to get it done quick. I think it is so good to cover anything. For concealer today, I'm going to be going through with the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. I'm just going to be popping a couple little swipes underneath my eyes. I was extremely tired yesterday, so I want to make sure I put a little bit more on. This stuff is exactly what it says. It is radiant and it's creamy, so it's really easy to apply. So to set my face today, I'm going to be going through with the RCMA translucent powder, no color powder. To save time, I'm just going to be taking a large brush and dusting that all over my face. I did kind of just bake really quick under the eye, but I'm not going to be like letting it sit there or anything. I just want to make sure this part of my under eye does not crease at all. But normally if I was doing like a glam video or, you know, getting ready for a special event, I would let it sit there for 10 minutes while I do the rest of my makeup, but I am just going to be setting the rest of it so I know my makeup will be secure for the rest of the day. For bronzer, I am going to be using this Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. This stuff is really good. I used to use it when I was at Sephora and I would put it on brides and girls for prom, and I felt like the best thing about it is that for everybody's complexion, you still get the same kind of look. It doesn't look too orange, it doesn't look too cool toned, it is just beautiful. Since this is going to be a very quick and minimal makeup look, I am going to be skipping any kind of contouring that I'm doing. I'm not going to be going through and doing anything really structured. I just want to bronze the face because I feel like you don't want your skin to look too dull once you put a full coverage or any kind of foundation on your face. For blush today, I am going to be using this Urban Decay. I want to say it's in the shade... I want to say it's Afterglow. I don't have it with me right now, but I do think it is Afterglow, and I'm just applying that right in the apples of my cheeks. For brows today, I am going to be using the ABH Brow Definer in the shade Taupe. I'm just going to be going through and filling in my brows as quickly and as accurately as possible. So I'm just going to fill in the bottom half and then kind of form an arch. And yeah, it doesn't take too long, but I feel like it kind of gets the job done. So my brows are naturally pretty thin, and they're very, very light. So my biggest thing is making sure my brows look very full and they have natural hairs, which is why I do like the brow definer. So I'm just going to go through and make sure my arch looks very natural, but it still kind of gives me that elongated effect. I am just showing you that I am at 4 minutes and 17 seconds. It doesn't matter if we are timing this, but I just wanted to show that it can be done in that certain amount of time. To set my brows today, I'm going to be using this Essence Make Me Brow, and this is, I think, the number one or maybe the lightest shade. I had actually never used this before, but I got it at Ulta, and I think I love it. It really just sets the brow but gives it that kind of color, just like the Benefit one does. To start the eye look today, I'm going to be using the shade Peach Smoothie by Makeup Geek, and I'm just going to go in with my E40 brush and blend that all into the lid.
Next, with that same Sigma E40 brush, I'm just going to be taking the shade Desert Sands by Makeup Geek. This is more of a, as Jaclyn Hill says, baby puke color, and I'm just going to be making that in the crease as well, just so there's a little bit more of a transition shade that is built up for that color that we're going to pop on the lid. So for the lid today, I am going to be using this shade Sequin. This is actually by ColourPop, and it's one of their Super Shock Shadows. It's a tongue twister. But yeah, so I'm just taking my finger, and I'm going to be pressing that all over my lid and kind of like dragging it across my lid. With these shadows, I don't think that I would use a brush because I think the payoff is better if you use your finger. So I did just take a Morphe brush and just kind of blended that in so that there isn't any kind of like harsh lines or there isn't like that halo around my eye. But yeah, I'm just taking this shadow and just packing it all over. When I did swatch it originally, it looked very gold. But when I put it on my eye, it looks very pink. But hey, it went with the look and I absolutely love these shadows. They're so, so pigmented and I think they're like $5. To add a little bit more of a dramatic effect, because it is me, I did add a little bit of Cocoa Bear by Makeup Geek, and I'm just taking a pencil brush by Sigma and putting that in my lower lash line and kind of V-ing it out into my crease as well. For lips today, I'm just going to be going through with a clear lip gloss. I mean, if you're in a rush and you really don't know what color you're going to put on your lips, I think a gloss is probably your best bet. So for highlight today, I am going to use the Becca Cosmetics Champagne Pop. This is like a holy grail. I think no matter what kind of skin tone you have, this stuff always works and it is really creamy. I did just want to state, if you don't generally use a highlight, this is optional for a simple makeup look. I personally really like adding it. It doesn't really take that much more time, but if you don't feel like that's enough, then I would just put bronzer and blush and that should be fine. So right here, I am just going to be popping on some mascara. I'm not doing any false lashes. I'm not even going to go through and pop on mascara forever, but I am just going to put a little bit on just to make sure my lashes do not look white like they usually do. So the only thing I did edit from this video is obviously me sitting and doing my mascara for about freaking 3 minutes, it feels like. So yeah, that's why the time looks a little bit shorter than on my phone.
Okay, I almost forgot to hit it. We're at 10 minutes and 3 seconds. Let's see what we have here. Okay, so I can't even look at my hair right now. I did get most of my face done. I would say this is a good, like, this is good. If you're running out of the house, I don't think this is too bad. I think anybody really could accomplish this. I didn't use too many products, so that's not bad. But yeah, I really love this. Let me put some spray on. This is the Milani Make It Last spray. This stuff smells so good, you guys. Like, I feel like it smells more like perfume than it does setting spray, but I need it. I need to know what. It's like a Victoria's Secret spray, if you guys know what I'm talking about. It's like, I can't even think of, like, Love Spell. That's what exactly what it smells like. But yeah. Oh. Here is the look. I don't even know what to call this, but it's very like light, but it still gives like a pop color. Like the eyes are still really pretty. So yeah, if you enjoyed this video and you'd like to see more videos like this, then please let me know in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.